as a young girl, I never saw myself as a scientist. So I am Natalie Edgecombe, and I'm a communications professional with a background in media production and most recently in education and outreach. And one of my recent roles was the education and outreach coordinator at the Montserrat Volcano Observatory. And that's the organization that monitors the active Sufre Hills volcano. When I got into science communication, I came from a media background.
The land I'm standing on is some of the youngest, newest land on the face of the earth. New land is formed when a volcano erupts.
I brought the skills that I had in that industry, and what I discovered was some natural abilities that I never realized that I had before. I've always seen myself as an artist, but I also came to realize that I am a little bit of a scientist too. You have this image of the person who is trained in science, the person who has been formally trained and gone through the university and gotten a PhD. And then you have the artist who has specialized in art. And then you have these people who are sort of in between, and they are excellent bridges. They are the people that the scientists can tap into to make the science understood. So from there, now I've relocated to Montreal, and I am presently the social media specialist for the Mad Science Group, which is a provider of STEM and STEAM education products of different kinds. So I feel my work matters because what I'm doing is helping to inspire the future generation of innovators in the world, because innovation drives change and it helps to make the world a better place. I feel that science and the arts are important in all aspects of everyday life, and that people benefit from learning these subjects and integrating them into their knowledge and their practice.
What would you like for girls to know?
I would want young girls to know, never let themselves be discouraged or pigeonholed by anybody's perspective or the world's perspective on what is commonly done by girls.
How do you feel about being a bridge between science and art?
Now, it's really a privilege to be able to combine the science and the art and use it to inspire other people.
Natalie has some really great advice.
Everybody has a purpose. Everybody has some things that they're good at. And I would like to see in this lifetime myself really achieve the maximum that I'm capable of.